Okay, students of class 9, let us today study about isotopes and isobars. What are isotopes? How we can understand about isotopes? Before that, we should know one thing about atomic number and also about atomic mass or mass number we can say. So, if you are talking about atomic number, then we all know that what is the meaning atomic number and what the sense we can get from atomic number. So let us study about the chapter structure of atom, in which we are going through isotopes, isobar, but before that atomic number. Number of protons in the atom is known as atomic number of an element. So number of protons, atomic number is equal to number of protons. Example, sodium has atomic number 11, that means number of protons in sodium is equal to 11. So that is the meaning atomic number. Mass number. When we talk about mass number, the sum of number of protons and number of neutrons is known as mass number. Is known as mass number. So mass number of an element, mass number of an atom is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Representation of an atom. Atomic number, mass number, an element. For example, take sodium. Sodium atomic number is 11 and mass number is 23. Similarly, carbon, 6 atomic number, 12 mass number. Similarly, calcium. Calcium has 14 atomic number, 14 mass number. So, when we talk about atomic number, here mass number. Similarly, nitrogen 7, 14, oxygen 8, 16. So this is the way we call it, how to represent an atom. We can represent an atom like this, atomic number, mass number like this. Now what is the meaning valency? The combining capacity of an element or an atom is known as valency of the atom, or we can say the number of electrons present in the last orbit of atom is known as valency of the atom or element. So, for example, sodium has one electron in its last orbit. So, valency of sodium is 1. Again, number of electrons required by an atom to complete its octet is also valency in case of nonmetals. For example, chlorine require one electron to complete its octet. Hence, valency is 1. So, similarly, we can go through some other idea: atomic number, mass number, valency. Well, let us go through isotopes and isobarons. So, when we talk about isotopes, what are isotopes? Actually, different atoms of same element having same atomic number but different mass number are called isotopes. Are called isotopes of that element. For example, hydrogen has 3 isotopes. Hydrogen has three isotopes. This is known as protium. Deuterium. Deuterium and tritium. Here what we say, atomic number is 1, but mass number is 1, 2 and 3 respectively. So hydrogen has 3 isotopes, namely protium, deuterium, deuterium and tritium. 3 isotopes hydrogen. And carbon has 3 isotopes. Carbon 12, carbon 13, and carbon 14. Carbon 12, carbon 13, and carbon 14. These are isotopes, 3 isotopes of carbon. Chlorine has 2 isotopes. Chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. So isotopes are actually the atoms of same element, but they're different. They are different in physical properties, not chemical properties. Chemical properties rather same. That is very important. So, properties of isotopes. Properties of isotopes. First, same atomic number. Different mass number. Same number of protons and electrons. Different number of neutrons. Number of neutrons different, and due to that mass number is different. Same chemical properties. Different physical property. Different physical properties. So these are some of the properties of isotopes. Isotopes are very important also sometimes, such as radioactive isotopes. Some of the radioactive isotopes which can emit alpha, beta, gamma rays. So we can define radioactive isotope also as those isotopes which can emit alpha, beta and gamma radioactive isotope. Are those isotopes? Which emit alpha, beta, and gamma rays that are harmful. So the use of radioactive isotope. Carbon 14 isotope is used to determine the age of old specimens of wood and animal origin. Radioactive isotope sodium 24 is used for examining the circulation of blood in the body. Carbon 14 is used to find the age of fossils. Sodium 24 is a radioactive isotope. Which is used to examine the circulation of blood, circulation of blood in the body. Radioactive phosphorus is very useful in agriculture field. And radioactive uranium is used as a fuel in nuclear reactor. Radioactive phosphorus P32 isotope is used is very useful in agriculture field. Radioactive cobalt releases gamma radiation. Radioactive iodine is used to check the working of thyroid gland. Radioactive iodine is used to check the function of thyroid gland. Function of thyroid gland. Okay, students, thank you. Thank you, students.